What's up everybody, welcome to Gamingtech. In this video we will be swapping out this GPU and install a new graphic card. Before, I need to clean this card because as you see it's quite dusty in the system. Also, it's an open case from Gamingtech Enio. The card that I was having installed on this system was 3060 Ti. Go. It is impossible to remove this card with your finger, so I'll have to use a sushi stick. Because my finger doesn't go in there. Fairly simple procedure. Asus is having a special feature where they have a button that pushes out the pin. I will be using this air duster, which is gonna do a phenomenal job here. Very easy job. Before, I was using compressor. It's more risky because you need to know exactly how much air pressure you want to build up. With this one, just hold your fans because it's quite strong. This is exactly how I clean this 3060 Ti Aorus Elite card. It wasn't that dusty, but I wanted to clean it before I store it away. This is the quick and easiest way to do it. And if you have any buildup left, with the wet tissue you can just get the rest of the buildup. We will be installing from Zotac 3080 Ti AMP Halo Extreme Edition. What's the difference between Extreme and the AMP Halo one? Well, this one has 3 pin, so higher TDP. Massive box, massive card. Probably this is gonna be also temporary in the system. I've seen some rumors that we might be getting new launch of cards. If we do, definitely gonna have 4090 in the system, that's for sure. I might even end up building a completely new system. This is the bracket that supports the card. It's a little bit finicky. I find it more for like look. Wasn't serving a good support whatsoever. And you can connect the RGB header also, 5 volt. Not that of a special box, to be honest. Fairly simple, but the card is very beautiful. For some reason, whenever I get a card from Zotac, they always perform so well. I'm not sure what's happening. That green towards the pink on the plastic shroud looks so good, especially under lightning. Massive card whatsoever. Beautiful. But I'm not gonna like it too much because it's gonna be a temporary card for me. It comes with dual BIOS, you have a quiet mode, you're supposed to install the Firestorm, which is not the best software, but that's the way you can control the RGB on the card itself also, which looks actually really good. Gotta clean this dust here. I will be using the air duster once again. This system also needs very big maintenance, to be honest. Need to flush out the water, need to remount the pump so I can remove that Noctua fan, which I haven't done. Tubing needs to be fixed. My wife did the tubing job here, so ever since that day I haven't touched it. You remember on one video where one of the tubes were leaking as well. So there has been a lot of events with this system. As you know, with water cooling it can happen. But this tool is amazing. Does my job so easy. It's light product. You charge it with the USB as well. This is how we install the graphic card. Once you hear that click sound, you know the card is installed correctly. That's the support bracket from MSI that I'm still using. Zotac one doesn't support anything. That's for sure. It just sits underneath and there's a gap. As you see, it's wobbling around if you pay attention closely. Three pins. These are extensions from cable mods. 1000 watt of power supply I'm using for this card, along with the system. The system is running 9900K. There's no overclock right now. That's the system, at least I render on here. I wanted to fix the cables. Obviously, there are these cable comms that are one piece, which would look much better, but since I don't have them right now here in the office, this is what I was improvising with. Man, my fingers were hurting because of this. Still waiting for the package from Glorious, so that's why I haven't started the process of building a new keyboard. Unfortunately, the postal office is having major issues with the packages, so everything that comes goes like some kind of quarantine. I have no idea why. It's disaster for sure. Only service that functions properly is UPS. And obviously they don't use UPS, they send it with DHL, so the package is actually stuck with them. I mean, it doesn't look the best. It looks funny, but it'll do it for now. Very nice card though. Very nice card. I was playing Division 2. We're getting around between 100 to 150 to 160 FPS on ultra wide resolution. Everything maxed out. Everything maxed out, absolutely. It's a phenomenal card. I call it baby 3090. Because of the less VRAM. Let's see if we can get a 3090 also. If we can't, I can guarantee you that all of the new cards will be in my hands. If you have any questions, you can ask me. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, do so also. Let's go, guys. Let's get that 1000 subscribers and give something to you guys as well. I'll see you on the next video. Take care of yourselves. Like and share. Let's go.